What's up, ladies and gentlemen? This is the Prince of YouTube, PS Compulsion, signing in here, aka Prince Anthony. And if you guys missed the last episode, you guys already know what I'm gonna say. Go back and check it out. But if you guys missed it, we did simulate to the All-Star break, and yes, we do have two All-Stars, although we have been playing like trash all season. I don't know how that happened, but congrats to Andre Drummond and Blake Griffin. But anyways, we're 15-41 for the NBA season thus far. We are definitely not making the playoffs, and we're not the worst team in the NBA anymore. So the New York Knicks, currently the worst team, but that doesn't matter because we're still in the running of getting the first overall pick and the second overall pick in the NBA draft, thanks to the New York Knicks and thanks to our tanking. So anyway, speaking of the New York Knicks, our last game of the season is against the Knicks. I find that hilarious. But anyways, it's time for us to simulate to the end of the season. We're not making the playoffs. We gotta get to the end of the season. It makes no sense playing any more games. So, to start the simulation off, we won two games against the Atlanta Hawks and the Miami Heat. I don't know why we insist on winning, but we really need to cut that BS out, especially this late in the season when we're not making the playoffs. But after those two games, we lost to the Pacers, we lost to the Spurs. I had a press conference. I always say that I'm satisfied with my staff, although my trainer is getting fired in the offseason. I'm just putting that out there. But then we beat the Cavs, we lost to the Toronto Raptors, we beat the Timberwolves. So why are we still insisting on winning games? That's all I want to know. But then my team got the memo and we lost three games in a row. That's lit. But then we won against the Miami Heat yet again. Why are we still winning games? We should lose the rest of the games that we play for the season. And that's exactly what started to happen. I got hit with a press conference. They told me, why did my team lose five games in a row? I'm like, that's my fault. It's me. I take all the blame for this. I'm encouraging the team to tank. And we just keep on losing and losing. But we did win a game against the Orlando Magic. But then the L's just kept on piling up. That's what I want to see. We are ending the season strong on a nice losing streak, but then we defeated the Memphis Grizzlies. And I stopped the simulation because before this last game against the New York Knicks, I wanted to see how bad that team was doing. And look at this. Since the All-Star break, the New York Knicks only won two games. They are beating us when it comes to tanking. They literally won two more games after the All-Star. That's insane to think about right there, bro. That's really insane. They are really the worst team in the NBA. That's crazy. That's making our pick that much more valuable. And looking at the Mygm lottery odds, the New York Knicks are projected to get the number one pick. And that's lit because that pick is going to us. So simulating the final game of the season, of course we are going to defeat the New York Knicks. And we end the season on a two-game winning streak, but that does not matter. I don't care. We don't have to tank anymore. The season is done. Finally, MVP goes to Giannis Antetokounmpo. Hopefully in real life he can win it, because I honestly think that he deserves it. Rookie of the Year goes to Luka Doncic. Of course he was going to win that. Well deserved. Congrats, Luka. Sixth Man of the Year goes to Spencer Dinwiddie. Defensive Player of the Year goes to Giannis Antetokounmpo. Most Improved Player of the Year goes to Donovan Mitchell, who is averaging 27 points per game. That right there is insane. Nick Nurse, Coach of the Year. Toronto Raptors, 63-win season. That's lit. John Murphy of the Oklahoma City Thunder, Executive of the Year. That's lit for OKC as well. So those are the awards. Time for the NBA playoffs. I got my money on the Golden State Warriors winning yet another championship. So I basically got the Golden State Warriors coming out of the West. And in terms of the Eastern Conference, I got my money on either the Celtics, Toronto Raptors, or Milwaukee Bucks making it out of the East. So now the Western Conference Finals, Golden State versus Oklahoma City Thunder. Eastern Conference Finals, the Indiana Pacers versus the Boston Celtics. And the Pacers made it to the finals against the Golden State Warriors. And the Golden State Warriors beat the Indiana Pacers 4-3. The Pacers almost came back and beat the Warriors down 3-0, if you guys didn't peep. But anyways, after the playoffs is done, the question that they asked me during the press conference was about financials. You know, we had a crappy season when the only question that they asked me during the press conference is about financials. Of course, I took the blame for it. I'm just taking the blame for everything this season. Don't worry. Trust the process. I got this, bro. Don't worry about it. I know what I'm doing. And then in terms of the funds to allocate, we really don't have that much money. I kind of see now why they told me about it and asked me about it. But at the same time, I didn't really care to answer that question, but we really didn't make a lot of money last season, which sucks. But hey, that's the nature of the game. Next season, don't worry, bro. We gonna bump our funds up, I'm telling you guys. So then I met with my owner, Lee Oliver. He wants me to get rid of Henry Ellison. He said, pack him up, get him out of here. I'm like, oh my goodness. He want me to trade somebody else. My owner is low-key a savage, bro. He's low-key a savage. But I'm gonna deal with that later. Welcome to the moment that everyone has been waiting for. Welcome to the NBA offseason. It's about to get lit. So, in terms of the player retirements, Dirk retired, Vince Carter, Jamal Crawford, Jason Terry, Tyson Chandler, my man Udonis Haslam from the Miami Heat, Kyle Korver, Ginobili, I thought he'd been retired, David West, Jose Calderon, Jameer Nelson, Damian Wilkins, and Aaron Aflalo, Hall of Fame inductees, Dirk Nowitzki, and Vince Carter, well deserved. But what about my man Manu Ginobili? He got his jersey retired, but he didn't make it into the Hall of Fame? That's some BS right there. That's really some BS. And then in terms of the rule changes, I decided to reject all of them. I don't want them to change the rules. Leave the rules exactly how they are, bruh. Just leave the rules. So now it is time, finally, for the NBA Draft Lottery. Things are really about to heat up and get lit right now. So right now we're projected to have the number one overall pick in the NBA draft, which is the pick we traded to New York, but it was top 10 protected, so we're going to get that pick back. And the number two overall pick in the NBA draft, which is the pick that the New York Knicks gave us, their unprotected pick. So now hopping straight into it, number five, the fifth pick in the NBA draft is going to the Atlanta Hawks. The fourth pick is going to the Miami Heat. And then there were three. We're really about to get the two top picks in the draft, bro. I'm so hyped up. So with the third pick in the NBA draft is going to the Memphis. Oh no, it goes to us. Oh my goodness, the pick that the New York Knicks traded us, the unprotected pick, falls to number three, meaning the pick for the Memphis Grizzlies increase. If they get the number one pick, I'm gonna be pissed. The second pick goes to the Memphis Grizzlies. Ladies and gentlemen, that means that with the number one pick in this year's NBA draft, it is going to the Detroit Pistons. Let's go. Let's get hyped up. We got the number one pick in the draft. Oh my goodness, it's lit. And that's the pick that we traded to the New York Knicks. We get that pick back. Top 10 protected. Whenever I trade picks, I'm putting protections on it now, bro. I'm really gonna do that. But now we have the number one overall pick in the NBA draft and the third overall pick in the NBA draft. Things are lit for us right now. Detroit Pistons fans, rejoice, because we are going to be lit. Take a drink every time I say the word lit. I'm gonna say that word all video, bro. Lit, 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 lit. But before we get back to draft business, I did make a few changes on my staff. I fired our trainer and I also fired our CFO. Of course, I had to get better staff members. I got myself a better trainer, B plus when it comes to training. My other trainer had way too many players that got injured last season, so I blame it on him. That's why he got fired. And also for my CFO, I brought in Christopher Murray. And if he looks familiar, that is because that's Mirko from NBA 2K18. Go back and watch my Bronx Kings, my GM mode, bruh. Just go back and watch it. But now back to business. We had the pre-draft workouts. And to be honest, I already know who I want to draft. A lot of people might get upset, but with that number one pick, I'm really, really leaning towards getting RJ Barrett. Now, I know a lot of you guys are probably like, what about Zion? What about Zion? I'm thinking about trading the third overall pick in the NBA draft and keeping the first pick and drafting RJ Barrett. And tell me what you guys think about that. Because if we get RJ Barrett, bruh, we are really going to be Markelle Fultz and RJ Barrett. And then if we trade the third overall pick in the NBA draft with somebody like, I don't know, Blake Griffin, maybe we'll be able to get something valuable back. I don't know. Take a look at these trades. Comment in the comment section below and let me know what you guys think I should do. Like I said, I'm thinking about using the number one pick, getting RJ Barrett, passing on Zion Williamson, and taking that third pick and Blake Griffin and trading those two assets for probably another star player. Because to be honest, if you guys really think about it, the Detroit Pistons, or Detroit as a whole, isn't really very marketable, to be honest. So no top tier free agent is gonna wanna sign with the Detroit Pistons just like that. It's not gonna happen. Detroit isn't New York, Los Angeles, Miami. It's not one of those free agent destinations. So trading for a top star using the third overall pick and Blake Griffin might be an option. I don't know, guys. I don't know. I'm gonna leave it up to you guys. Comment in the comment section below. But I know for a fact that we are getting RJ Barrett. That is not changing. We definitely gotta get him on the squad. But I don't know what to do with the third overall pick. I don't know. I really don't know. Leave a comment in the comment section below. Comment, comment, comment. Let me know what I should do. This is the Prince of YouTube signing out. Let's go, Pistons. We about to be lit. Number one pick, baby.